love, it isn't what you expect. This brand of love only comes from God, laying a hand on your chest, reaching into your soul and extracting the best. Who he was, who she was, had to be casualties. So consider this more like a eulogy. Removing incomplete remnants of you and me, relics of our past, separate lives laid to rest. Until at the end, all that's left standing is this union of we, beautifully. Being this in tune doesn't come without a sound check. In you, I discovered an everlasting crescendo.
We always knew each other from church. We're all church babies, so.
We were children long ago. We didn't meet formally. Our families have been around each other's families for decades.
We knew each other in passing, and I was real good friends with his brother, Ricky. And one day, Kenny had something go on with him, and I had a similar situation. So, you know, we met up for dinner and talked, and it just sparked into something.
I received this text message before 1 o'clock in the morning. He woke her up and told her that you and my brother need to talk and get some things out because you both lost a parent. And you guys, I guess you can help each other. And from then on, we agreed to meet. Lynn stretched out her hand to me because I was the guy that was drowning. So in essence, she basically saved my life. And that's the God's honest truth. She really did. So that's how we officially met, over dinner talking about our parents.
Even the little weird stuff about them was the same. We liked the same food. Our kids are similar. It's funny. Kadir and Brandon are twins. The way they act, just the mannerism, everything about them.
Second thing that caught me was her voice. She sang with almost everybody's music group. She has such an awesome voice. I told her she's gonna turn out to be like her Aunt Carmen Moreno.
We just had a lot in common, so it really was a friendship that turned into love.
What stands out, what always stood out about Lynn was she always appeared serious, but her natural beauty, it was captivating. It's always been that way. To me. I never thought to pursue because, you know, we both were living life on our sides of the fence, so to speak, so I wouldn't dare disrespect her and whatever was going on in her life, and I had things going on in my life, but as long as I knew the Marinos, she's always been a beautiful person outside and in.
He is a gentleman. He opens doors. He's always trying to make sure that I'm weighed on hand and foot. Even when I try to do stuff for him, he's like, no.
She's totally selfless. She's always putting herself last. And I get on her about that, especially when it comes to me. I do the macho man thing all the time, but she's like, come on, let me help you. And I'm not used to that.
So he's just loving and caring. He takes good care of his family. He's just a really good guy.
I told her and I told my pastor friends, wow, she's my sedative. She calms me down. Sometimes she doesn't have to say a word. Just a simple look at me. It's like, you know, it's not worth all that energy. She can look at me or she'll touch my arm and it's like I'm reduced to being calm. Wow.
Times, you know, I drag my feet on things and he always like, oh, we gotta get this together. You gotta push and get things together. It kind of annoys me though, but it helps me get better.
Don't you leave me, don't you go nowhere. You better stay with me for the rest of my life and the beginning of eternity because I need you, I love you, and everything that I have belongs to you, including my heart. So I don't want my heart back now, she can have it.
He has a very hard cover, but he's a big teddy bear inside, and I don't think anybody knows that about him. Very softy.
I'm Ken Buckmon. I'm the future husband of Lynn Marie Moreno.
My name is Lynn Marino, and I'm the future Mrs. Buckmon.